Mets fans, how are you feeling? Let's make it clear if you're new here, not a Mets fan. I just seem to have a hat for every occasion. I'm an Angels fan all the way, but we are gonna be wearing the Mets hat for this video. You just traded for Francisco Lindor, one of the best shortstops in baseball, along with Cookie Carrasco from the Indians. Trading away Andrés Giménez, Ahmed Rosario, Josh Wolf, and Isaiah Green. That sounds like a pretty good deal to me. I know you guys are gonna miss Mr. Smile. He was a huge personality to your team. I would too. But let's talk about how scary this Mets lineup is gonna be with the addition of Francisco Lindor. You got Brandon Nimmo and Jeff McNeil leading off, two good contact hitters. Then you put Lindor in that three hole, a switch hitting shortstop who can hit for power and average. You like that. Then you got the former rookie of the year, Pete Alonso, behind him, who's got all that power inside of him. Michael Conforto right after him, who can also hit for power and has a good bat in general. Dominic Smith and JD Davis, solid hitters to have at the bottom of your lineup. And then the new addition, James McCann, who I also forgot they had. This lineup is looking very good. So I'm going to be very disappointed if the Mets don't do anything with it, because they always have these expectations every year. A lot of people, a lot of the fans put these expectations on them and they fall short no matter who they have. And you might look at it like a situation like my Angels. You're like,
okay, they got all these bats, but where is the pitching?
They got pitching. You got a two-time Cy Young Award winner with Jacob DeGrom, one of the best pitchers in the league. Then they re-signed Stroman. He's going to be decent for them. Then you added Cookie in that trade, so he's going there. David Peterson and Steven Matz at the bottom of rotation. And then later in the season, they're going to get Noah Syndergaard back, who throws heat, and he is one of the most dominant. So you got the bats, you got the arms. The only thing I think they can improve on is their bullpen, but a lot of MLB teams need bullpen help. Going into this MLB season, I bet a lot of people are gonna be expecting the Mets to do big things. You're going up against the Phillies, the Nationals, the Marlins, and the Braves. Your top competitor is gonna be the Braves, but I think you can really go toe-to-toe with all the other teams in that league, be better than them. So now is your chance, Mets fans. You got this stacked lineup, you got a good rotation, and I also always got to come back to this: how does this affect Trevor Bauer? Throwing on my Angels cap for this one, Trevor. I see you're calling fans for your videos, so if you want to call another Angels fan, I'm gonna talk about this like I talked about Blake Snell and Yu Darvish going to the Padres and how I thought that would affect Trevor Bauer. I'm gonna talk about it the same way. I'm gonna give reasons that he could and reasons that he could not. Obviously, signing with the Mets, you're thinking, oh, they got a rotation, they got the pitching. That's exactly what you want. You want to be surrounded by other good players. But maybe this Lindor trade was them pulling themselves out of the market for Trevor Bauer. That's what a lot of you were saying when they got Blake Snell and Yu Darvish on the Padres. They're like, oh, they made those moves because they're not going to get Trevor Bauer. That could be the same case here, but this is a position player and another pitcher. So this is another reason I think they might be pulling themselves out of the Trevor Bauer market. If they are still in the Trevor Bauer market, how are you going to look at it? Are you going to be upset that they didn't think of you first and that got these other guys instead? But they're also guys that were your former teammates, so you do have some love towards them, but I don't know. That's the only reason I could think of for why not. I kind of accidentally explained both sides. Like I said, you could put yourself in a good rotation with a lineup that has tons of talent. That's also what he could do with the Dodgers, which I really don't want him to do. Or you could look at it at the other side, and maybe they pulled themselves out. They're not going to give you as much money, so you want to go to another team. And if there's another team you should go to, I hope it's my Angels. We have not been spending big on free agents. We haven't traded for anybody. I'm sure they will give you the money that you want, because we need pitching so bad in the bullpen, in the rotation. We need it all over, and we need somewhere to start. You got beautiful weather, you got a great lineup, and we need somebody to lead our rotation, and I would be happy to have Trevor Bauer lead our rotation. Anyways, Mets fans, comment down below how you feel about your team getting Francisco Lindor. I want to offer you a thank you for getting him out of the American League. That's one scary batter that we get to avoid this season. Thank you. Your lineup is stacked, you got a good rotation, and you didn't really have to give away much to do it. So I'm sure you're feeling good, and I will see you guys next time.